Wales.
This is the technical difficulties. We're playing Citation Needed. Joining me today, he reads books. You know, it's Chris Josh.
Hello, hello.
Everybody's favourite, Gary Brannan. Gary Brannan.
Well, I'm a cock.
And the bounciest man on the internet, Matt Gray.
Sir, this is a pub.
In front of me, I've got an article from Wikipedia, and these folks can't see it. Every fact they get right is a point and a long. And a special prize for particularly good answers, which is... And today, we are talking about the Battle of Shishguard. The Battle of Shishguard.
Is a Shishguard a Shishguard?
Yes.
Were they warriors holding up fish as shields?
Well, like a flat fish and then a swordfish in the other hand.
Oh!
Squelching your way forward and making a...
Now, that's a proper combination.
Yeah, or a pint. No.
I'm going to say Wales.
Yes, and have a point.
It's a place.
Yes, yeah. I learned it in a...
I learned it from the shit podcast.
Well, there we go. Oh. We all have different roots.
Shishguard is a place in Wales, and this is where the battle took place.
Really?
They named the battle after the battle, unlike all the other battle naming conventions, which were a good 50 battles away.
Yeah, so it's like in World War II when they switched the battle signs around.
That's a fair point. Battle and actual site of the Battle of Hell is debatable, for instance. So, yeah, it has been done.
Battle of Waterloo, you could see the remains in the toilet to this day.
That's true.
This was a battle in Shishguard. Who might have been attacking?
Fish.
Oh, no. 1992 to 1797, who might Britain have been battling then?
Tom does the wheels
spin
and land as it does 50% of the time on France.
Ah! Playing the hits!
We are coming.
This was an attempt to land a force of troops in Britain to support another invasion.
So they went via Wales?
Yes. So where might have been the primary attack force headed?
Ireland?
Yes.
Oh, hang on.
Because it's Ireland. Boat-wise, is on the way to Ireland, isn't it?
Shush!
Because if you're boating from the France bit, you get to the island bit before you get to the island bit, don't you? If you're coming from the right top right bit of the island.
Yes.
So what was this invasion force intended to do?
Outvade.
This was the third attempt at invasion. Why did some of the earlier ones fail?
Fart!
Yeah.
A new one!
You're absolutely right.
Oh, mais oui, le bilios. Le winili. C'est grand.
So the Wales-bound invasion force, four troops from the Black Legion, under the command of an Irish-American Colonel William Tilliam.
Were they the Black Legion from our side?
No, this is... I'm translating. La Legion Noire. Okay.
Who clapped?
Just once clap. As well, which... Four troops. Invading Wales, essentially.
Did anyone ask the Welsh? Sounds dreadfully rude.
Well, you say that. There was a bit of a response when 14 troops arrived. What were these troops made up of?
Horses?
Infantry.
Horses riding men.
Six were regular soldiers that Napoleon had not required to conquer Italy.
So, the beam.
Yes. 800 were regulars. Now, what does that mean?
Factory. Maybe some chips.
Regulars are paid, aren't they?
Not
special force, but not in an SAS kind of way.
Yeah.
They're specialising you wouldn't trust him with anything.
Yes.
Right.
So we have...
This is good, isn't it?
We have the beam, and we have the regulars. It includes Republicans, deserters, Republican deserters, and pub deserters.
Nice. At least that last category is probably not going to run away.
You know, discipline broke down among us. There's the setup for the battle, if you like. I don't know what... There is probably a formal term for the armies of massive fascists.
It is. It's the armies of massive fascists.
What's in the British command?
T.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine.
A horse on horseback arrives to instruct the commanding officer. And the commanding officer was William. What was his immediate reaction?
More brandy!
Yes!
We'll fire them in the minute.
The thing is, when the
now you may speak.
The next title here is But Averted.
Ah.
So what happened?
Pint of rum.
Oh, you know what?
2 pints of rum.
Mercy, brandy!
The recruits had collapsed once they discovered the local supply of wine. Why wine? Why Wales? Why wine in Wales?
Washed.
Yes.
So port probably sank and some bottles washed up that were full of probably port.
Now, the French are approaching. The British are approaching. Under the command of Lord Cord, whose HQ is where?
More.
It doesn't have to rhyme.
Lord Cornmore.
Lord Willard of Herring.
I mean, no, the local pub, the Royal.
Really?
He set up in the pub. That was his HQ. The French realised that the British were British, so as the line they go back to their camps for the night. The next morning, two French officers turned up. Why do you send only two officers to the opponent's HQ?
Because one of them's a horse and has been riding on the back of the horse.
I'm looking for a specific word here.
Surrender!
Surrender. Absolutely right. Thank
Sorry.
You,
yes,
sarcastic applause.
In insert French here, yes. Cut them to the floor. There we go, there we go.
Yeah, they wish to negotiate a conditional surrender, and Lord Cor said...
Nah.
Yes. The French surrender. The British surrender. Tilliam is imprisoned briefly and then surrender. There is something about this invasion, though. There is something. 1797. There is something about the invasion of Britain in 1797.
That will be the last invasion of Britain.
As we record this.
Congratulations, Gary. You win this show. You have won American. So with that, we say thank you to Chris George, to Gary Brannan, to Matt Gray. I've been Tom Scott, and we'll see you next time.
I'm going to say Wales. 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 Wales.